Hey guys, what's poppin', what it is, and what's up?
Hey guys, welcome back to Simmy, and today I will be filming for Sophie's Vanity.
So, I'm in my bathroom, so you already know what that means. We're testing another razor out. Okay, that wasn't even funny.
You might be wondering who's on your screen right now, and I'm not talking about me. Well, that's Simmy Green, but I call her Simone. Today we're gonna be comparing our curly hair routines.
I was doing my wash day routine. Okay.
Today we're actually going to be doing a hair video, a wash day, and guess what? This time I'm natural. It's been about 2 weeks and I had a twist out, then I took off the twist out after a week and then put it in a puff. So it's been in a puff for about a week and some days.
Okay, so it's only actually been like 3 or 4 days since I washed my hair. I usually wait like a week at least until I wash my hair, but you know, I just need a little refresher, okay?
I actually have not deep conditioned since I went natural, so I better hop on the wave, am I right?
Yeah, I need to wash my hair. And that's what you're gonna see today. All right, stay tuned.
So let's go ahead and hop to the video. Well, into my shower.
My picture.
So after wetting her hair a little bit, she goes ahead and grabs her face wash and exfoliates, rubs it into her skin. Of course, like most people, she likes to get her hair nice and wet before shampooing and cleansing the scalp, so right now she's just running the water through her hair. Then she's gonna go in with some Garnier Fructis shampoo, you know, something light, and she's gonna go ahead and scrub that, rub that mainly on her scalp to get her scalp clean. After she lets it sit for a quick minute, she rinses it off. Something that she does that I don't do is she squeezes the excess water out of her hair. Can't relate. She also does a little bit of light finger detangling in between shampoo and conditioner. So, taking the Shea Moisture shampoo, I'm going to be using this to cleanse my scalp and my hair. I wet my hair until it's completely soaked, and I mean dripping wet, because if not, that means the water has not fully penetrated my hair, and none of my shampoo, conditioner, or deep conditioner will work to its full benefit. So I don't know if a lot of people do this, but I like to cleanse the outside of my hair where all the gel, products, leave-in is mostly built up. Then I go ahead and grab my clips and my detangling brush and I move on to the in-depth cleansing wash method that I use. So I basically section off half my head and then break the other half into two pieces. Once I do that, I take the shampoo, fully cleanse my scalp, and then cleanse my hair by dragging the lather down. Taking her Garnier Fructis conditioner, she just rubs that all over the ends of her hair. Once that's in, she uses her fingers to finger detangle. This method is used by curly girls all over the world to minimize breakage and shedding. Not to mention, you get to see how your hair's been shedding over the week. Sit down. My conditioning routine is a little bit more intense. I'll be using a Dove conditioner, rubbing that all over each section. This conditioner is going to provide me the slip I need to detangle. Big boy, did you pull that hate? And you make me feel like the first time, huh? I don't get tired of the way that I hate. Yeah, got more milk steak than Khalees. Ain't met a nigga who can handle me. Detangling from ends to roots is extremely important to ensure the least amount of breakage and the least amount of tension on your scalp. Once I'm done detangling, I rinse out the conditioner and I do my twist and clip method. Essentially what I do is two-strand twist the roots of my hair almost to the end and I twist the ends in my hand. Then I take the clip at the base of the twist, which allows the rest of the hair to stick out, but securing the roots. Ever since I discovered this is the way that my hair clips the best, I haven't stopped. Another difference between our hair care routines is that my shampoo and conditioning routine is not separate. They work together and I do each section separately to make sure that each section is properly cleaned and detangled. So instead of finger detangling and then immediately rinsing out the conditioner, Simone actually goes ahead and washes her body with some Dove soap. Once she's done with that, she rinses the conditioner out of her hair. What I've noticed is that the Dove conditioner is amazing for conditioning and detangling. It's not that great for deep conditioning. So I'm taking this Shea Moisture Deep Conditioner. If you're very picky about your consistencies, this is the consistency of the deep conditioner. Once that's applied, I do my twist and clip method. I let the deep conditioner sit for 30 minutes and then I rinsed it out.
Hi guys! So, this is what my hair looks like dry on the first day. It has nothing in it, nothing at all, no product. Yeah, this is what it looks like. Right.
So this is what my hair looks like fresh out the shower. If you have a similar hair type, comment down below because I love to see what you do. This is my hair fresh out the shower, a little bit moist. And this is my hair in a flat twist after using two nourishing products. I use this as I am twist cream to twist my hair. Being thick, it's still very malleable and it has a little bit of a jelly bounce to it. Once the hair has the leave-in and twist cream in it, I decide to do a two-strand twist. Now I'm just twisting the rest of my hair. Pillow talk, turns into sweet dreams, sweet dreams, turn into coffee.
stereophonic sound for the home is recorded on two separate tracks, each one giving special emphasis to certain sections of the orchestra, as heard from those positions. Now, when played back simultaneously on two separate systems, the sounds are blended together to achieve a new dimension in sound impossible to obtain in a monaural recording.